Hello everyone, it's me here from the Vlog Academy and I'm in my favourite place surrounded by cameras and geeky stuff. And today I want to talk about raising the quality of your live streaming or video recordings from your laptop. So I'm currently recording this through my internal FaceTime camera on my MacBook Pro and I'm going to switch over to my Sony Alpha 7 III to see what an external camera can do, if there's any difference that we can notice. So here we go, I'm going to switch right over and let's see if there's any difference. Wow, I can see a difference, can you? And this is why it could be worth for you to look into getting an external camera hooked up to your computer system when you're doing live streaming. And we're going to have a look at how you can do that. So we're going to have a look at a few different systems and what you need to connect them to your laptop or computer. So first of all, why would we want to do that? Well, even in the latest MacBook Pro, the internal camera is not the best quality you can get. And in this, for example, it's only 720 resolution. It's not even 1080. So the resolution is the quality of the video. And we're now using 4K and above for a lot of production. You don't need that for live streaming, but 720 just doesn't give you the best resolution you can. So what can we do then? Well, a lot of people, they get an external webcam, something like this, and they come from, you know, £15 up to a couple of £100. And they're not difficult to connect at all. They come with a USB and you're ready to go. You just set it up on your computer and you've already got a better quality, depending on the quality of your webcam, of course. I think the best one on the market right now that we are looking at is the Brio 4K webcam. So that's a big step up from a 720 internal webcam, but it's still not going to give you the flexibility that you might want now to up your game. So instead of a webcam that doesn't necessarily have that many features and options to it, we can connect an external normal camera, digital camera obviously. So some of you might actually have something like this already at home or in your office. This is a camcorder, this is a Panasonic. They are absolutely fine to connect to your computer for live streaming. They're really good actually. And they are very good at automatic, so you don't need to faff around with lenses and settings and all of that. And focus is extremely secure. So if you have one of these, I would start with that and see the difference you get in your output. As long as it's 1080, preferably 4K, you will be absolutely fine. So how do you connect your camcorder to your laptop then? Well, you need one main thing, and that's a capture card. And the capture cards come in different sizes, shapes and forms and prices, of course. We have the Elgato capture cards, for example, that rate quite highly, and they can be as small as a little USB stick. So you just put them in the USB socket on your computer, or if you're on Mac, you need, of course, an adapter with USB slots. And then you can put it in and you put the camera cable, which I will talk about in a second, into the capture card and off you go. Now they also come in larger versions. So this is kind of a mid-size with two inputs and one output. And this one is called Flint LX. Flint LX. And these capture cards, they range from around £100 up to several hundred pounds. If you are looking to have several cameras, so you want a little mixer box, then there is something called Blackmagic, which can take several cameras and you can choose between the cameras as you are live, which is pretty cool if you're using an in-between streaming platform. And then the cable you need from the camera is an HDMI cable. So it's a classic cable as such, and you probably have one from your TV to some sort of a box usually, or your game station. But the HDMI cables for the cameras are unfortunately all different sizes. So you need to know what size HDMI cable your camera takes. These three cameras in front of me have three different size sockets. So the HDMI cable come with five different sizes, A, B, C, D, and E. So have a look at the socket, read the specs of your camera, and it will tell you what size HDMI you have. Now, another important thing is that you need to have a clean HDMI output so that you can disregard all the information and all the display notes that you get in the camera, so that you don't have that going on in your live recording, obviously. These are a few things that you need to be aware of when you connect a camera to your laptop or computer, but it doesn't have to be very complicated at all. So if you have a camcorder, just get the correct HDMI cable, get yourself a capture card and slot it in, and then you can choose, for example, if you're on Zoom, you will be able to choose when you see your video camera settings. You can choose between your internal face cam, it's usually called, or the external, and it will probably pick up on the capture card and not the camera model, so that can be a little bit confusing. So remember the brand of your capture card, and then you will see when it pops up on your screen. And then, of course, if you have a DSLR or if you have a camera where you can change the settings, you can zoom in, you can change the exposure, you can even change the depth of field depending on how you're setting up. So much more settings to play with if you enjoy that kind of thing. But if you want to keep it simple, start with a better quality webcam and then work your way up if you feel you need it. So I hope this was helpful. I hope you're excited about this as much as I am. And if you have any questions, as always, of course, just ping them in the comment box below or get back to me by DM. Now, I have a training course, which is really short and sweet, an online course that you'll do in about an hour, but it will show you everything you need to know to be able to set up at home. Everything from tripods to lights to microphones and how to position your camera or laptop when doing this live streaming. And I'm showing you in a very simple way in your living room or kitchen, or if you're in your workshop or office, it doesn't matter, but you will see exactly how I set it up so you can just learn how to do it in a really good way and what you need to just raise the quality of your live streaming sessions or pre-recorded videos a little bit. So that's all for this video. I'll be back soon with more for you if you are interested in video, online video, teaching online and sharing information. Bye for now.